It's a whole hoax.
The impeachment inquiry intensifies. I'm Adrian Pederson today on Upfront.
The president, as I interpret that, is trying to get to the truth.
Republican Senator Ron Johnson on the controversy, the questions he has, and his trip to Ukraine. Plus, Supreme Court candidate Ed Falone on what he learned by losing in 2013. And struggling golf courses, what cities and counties are doing about the growing trend.
Taking on the issues important to Wisconsin. This is Upfront with your host, Adrian Pederson.
Thank you for joining us. Wisconsin's Republican U.S. Senator says he doesn't see anything wrong with the call President Trump had with Ukraine's president. We have an interview with Senator Johnson today, and we'll hear from him in just a moment. The president's Ukrainian phone call is, of course, at the center of the impeachment inquiry House Democrats have launched. The president last week not only repeated his request for Ukraine to investigate his rival Joe Biden and Biden's son's business dealings in Ukraine, he also called on China to do the same.
China should start an investigation into the Bidens, because what happened in China is just about as bad as what happened with Ukraine.
Senator Johnson says the president just wants the truth. Johnson visited Ukraine last month, and our Matt Smith talked with him about that trip and the Ukrainian controversy.
We've seen some subpoenas this past week, and we'll likely see more in the weeks to come. Curious from your perspective, whether you look at the State Department, lawmakers, or the White House, should everyone cooperate with this investigation?
Well, first, it's important to state what an important concept, executive privilege, and keeping confidential conversations between the President of the United States and other foreign leaders is to just conducting governance and foreign policy. I think it's a real shame that what's happened here has resulted in the release of conversation between President Trump, President Zelensky. It's not good for President Zelensky, those kind of conversations, and any president does require advisors to be able to offer very candid advice, sometimes out-of-the-box thinking, that really should not be made available to the public. So we really are hampering not only this president's, but future president's ability to do their job.
Should the president not have authorized the release of what the White House put out in terms of the transcript of that call?
I mean, I'll leave that up to the president. I won't criticize it. I just think it's harmful. It was unfortunate that this has happened.
Should the White House cooperate with the investigation?
Yeah, I think the White House will, but, you know, from a reasonable standpoint, too. I don't think Congress should be demanding everything. I conducted the investigation under the Hillary Clinton email scandal for years. I never subpoenaed anything. Didn't get a whole lot. We accepted what we got, and we kept moving forward with it.
Well, do you think you'll be called to testify, and will you cooperate?
I would certainly cooperate. I have no idea. Obviously, I have firsthand knowledge. I spoke to the president on August 31st before I took my trip to visit President Zelensky in Ukraine. I think it was September 4th or September 5th. Mm-hmm. Probably to get that date down. But, I called the president because I'd heard that he was considering not offering that support and equipment for Ukraine. And so I called him up trying to talk him into releasing that support and giving me the authority to tell President Zelensky he was coming.
In that conversation, did the president mention Joe Biden at all?
The president has been very consistent in terms of what he has laid out as his rationale, and has been really consistent before he even took office. He is upset that Europe isn't stepping up the plate and doing more. And so he really concentrated on just overall corruption in Ukraine, which President Zelensky fully understands. It's why he got elected. His mandate is to defeat corruption, as he put it. And so President Trump really laid out those two rationales. Ron, you understand what a corrupt society that is. No doubt about it, he has hard feelings about some of the rumors flying in terms of possible DNC Hillary Clinton campaign involvement with Ukraine, trying to dig up dirt on Paul Manafort, maybe even dig up dirt on Joe Biden back then, prior to the Joe Biden deciding not to get in the presidential primary on the Democrat side. So, the president, as I interpret that, is trying to get to the truth. And I have no problem with that. He's the chief law enforcement officer of America. He would like to find out what led to this entirely false narrative of Russian collusion with his campaign that has literally put his administration through the ringer, hampered his ability to govern. I want to know that. I think the American people have the right to know, did something happen? Or if nothing happened, they need to know that as well.
And did the president ask you to bring up Hillary Clinton or Joe Biden in your conversation with Ukraine's president?
No, absolutely not. My conversation, again, he focused on corruption, and he was concerned about the fact that Europe just doesn't honor its commitment to NATO. Ukraine's in their backyard, not ours. You know, why doesn't Europe do more? And what I do say at the very end of that conversation, you know, he had to get go because he had a hurricane to deal with. He said, Ron, I got a hurricane to deal with, but you'll probably be happy with my decision. So I think he was already leaning that direction. He just wasn't willing to give me the go-ahead. And then when I was in Ukraine, you know, President Zelensky was obviously concerned about it, far more concerned about what that represented potentially in terms of support, so we could convey, you know, from standpoint of Congress, I think the administration, fully supportive of Ukraine and its people. He's far more concerned about that than the dollar amount, although that's important. Yeah. But he never, ever expressed any concern that he's being pressured or felt pushed or threatened in any way, shape, or form.
Was Joe Biden brought up in that conversation with Ukraine's president?
I don't believe so.
So you did not ask him to investigate the Bidens or the Clintons?
Senator Murphy talked about the fact that right now Ukraine has broad bipartisan support in Congress, and if... And you kind of warned President Zelensky, if you know, if you cooperate with Rudy Giuliani or interfere in our election, you know, that's not going to be good for you. But that was Senator Murphy that brought up that political aspect. I was just trying to show support for Ukraine.
Why not ask him to investigate Hillary Clinton or Joe Biden or help in that if you are so concerned about it?
Well, first of all, I think those investigations are ongoing. I have been conducting investigations. I've been trying to gather information. I want to get to the truth of a whole host of issues. Yeah. You know, I've got a long list of questions. Maybe at some point in time I'll publish them on different areas, but we've been pretty patient. One of the problems Congress always has in its own investigations, if there's a criminal investigation, a special counsel, you know, the excuse always given is, well, we can't give you that information because we have a criminal probe. We don't want it to, in any way, shape, or form, harm our prosecution. So that's just one of the constraints the Congress faces always in these investigations.
You've talked about what the White House released a fair amount and your thoughts on the conversation. Is this the right framing in terms of, did the president ask a favor of a foreign government to investigate someone he may be running against in 2020?
Now, I interpret it as the president was asking a favor to get to the truth. You know, if you were president of the United States and a completely false narrative was perpetrated somehow, somebody planted this story that ended up resulting in special counsel, I'd want to find out, how did this all happen? You know, who started this rumor? You know, why did I end up getting special counsel? I mean, I can understand the president's frustration, his willing and his desire to find out exactly what happened. I want to find out, and I know a fair amount of President Trump supporters would like to know that as well.
Does anything concern you about this phone call?
Not really. Again, I have a different interpretation because I had firsthand knowledge here. I look at that as a pretty gracious phone call, basically congratulatory, and the President Trump, he's asking him to do a favor, you know, help us get to the truth, which is entirely appropriate for the Chief Law Enforcement Officer of America. We have cooperative agreements with a host of countries in terms of criminal investigations and aiding in prosecution. So to me, that, you know, from that standpoint, it would be totally appropriate.
Whether it's a political opponent or not.
Again, I know he mentioned Joe Biden, but he's also trying to get to the heart of some of these other rumors swirling around of, you know, possibly Hillary Clinton campaign involvement, possible DNC involvement. I don't know. I'm not making any accusations. I'm just saying there are some legitimate questions that have remained unanswered. And by and large, the press has been very incurious about an awful lot of these issues.
You and Senator Grassley written several letters this past week to the Inspector General with some concerns over some changes to the process.
Well, you know, right on the form that's actually used here, it says kind of a disclaimer saying, you know, if this is not firsthand information, we're probably going to not move forward with this complaint as an urgent concern, which means immediate transmittal to Congress because it's so urgent, rather than going through the normal process. I'm all for whistleblower protection, but I also recognize all whistleblowers are not created equal. Sometimes whistleblowers have political axes to grind, and you have to be concerned about that as well.
Does so the whistleblower have a political grind, do you believe?
I have no idea. I don't know who the whistleblower is. So he or she deserves protection, but it should go through the normal channels. I am concerned about how that got leaked, I think inappropriately, but before it certainly should have, because it went through the process, the whistleblower to the IG, to the to the Director of National Intelligence, to the Office of Legal Counsel, both of those entities said this is not an urgent concern, this should not be immediately transmitted to Congress, and yet it was.
Last week on the show, ABC News' political director said, from the White House's perspective, you should be one of the top Republican senators that the White House should be concerned about in terms of whether you will support the president no matter what the investigation finds.
I'm going to support getting the truth out. I just want to get the truth. I'm not supporting or backing up any perspective. I'm just trying to convey, first of all, my firsthand knowledge, and convey that perspective. But in general, I want to get to the truth. There are a lot of unanswered questions that the American people have the right to know.
You can see our entire interview with Senator Johnson on our website, the upfront section of WISN.com. Coming up, candidate for state Supreme Court, Ed Falone. Does he see a high court divided by ideology? And later, it's a question in Wisconsin and really across the country, what to do with the golf courses that are expensive to maintain and fewer people want to play.
Upfront, brought to you by WPS Health Insurance.